Come on!
The inventory sheets. 23 cans of soda. 38 bags of chips. 60 microwavable dinners. All missing.
That's weird. Maybe.
You're not in trouble, kid. As long as we come to some kind of deal.
What kind of deal?
You stole from me for 3 months. I didn't know until a few days ago. Sorry. That is a particular skill I can make use of. See, aside from running this fine retail establishment, I take in wayward boys and girls, much like yourself, to do my dirty work for me.
Like, girls, there's like two girls. They don't even talk to each other.
Three if we include you.
Yeah, very funny. Four if we include this guy.
This is my son. Introduce yourself.
Mickey.
Travis.
How many times do I have to tell you? You are little Mickey.
No one calls me that.
Hey, Uncle Robinson. Hey, Mickey. Who's the kid?
He's the one who's been stealing from us.
Oh, are you gonna kill him here?
So, what can we do for you, sweetheart?
Nothing, I was just gonna get my coat.
Have you seen Raleigh? He wasn't at breakfast this morning.
No, I haven't, but we're supposed to go to Dynamica together tonight.
No. You both will be going with us.
No, I already made
it's
the plans
final.
To go. Okay.
So, can I go now?
Not so fast, kid. You got some ID?
Here are my prepubescent credentials.
That'll do. I also need your phone number.
Here you go.
Ah. All right, Mr. Travis Malone. You are free to go.
Wait, not in trouble?
Let's just say your application is on file, and when we have need of your services, I know exactly where to find you. I'll get the fuck out. Put that with the rest of them.
Hey, dog.
Alright, he's onto us, okay? I know that he knows.
Oh, baby, calm down, alright? Just first tell me what you're talking about.
Uncle Robinson! I told him tonight that you were gonna be the one to take me to Dynamica. He insisted that we both go with him. I know him. That was a threat. He might kill us.
Lola, you're being paranoid, baby, alright? He's only worried about your safety. You ride with them, I'll ride separate, and midway through the third round, excuse yourself to the ladies' room. Your ruby will go down in the fourth round. I'll collect the winnings, and we'll meet at the ice cream shop at the end of Warren Boulevard, alright?
Alright. I trust you, Raleigh.
You feel better?
Yeah, a little, I guess. I just feel better once we're out of here tonight.
That's my girl, so...
Raleigh.
Come on. You're wearing that red dress I like so much.
Yes, I am. You're such a goon. Too bad you're gonna have to wait till later tonight to see it, though.
We'll have to make up for that. Right, I've gotta go, baby, alright? I'll see you tonight. Good luck.
Alright, good luck.
They paid for. Ruby goes for the body shot and sucks Ainsley with a right hook to the face as Ruby Valentius goes down to the fourth. She is not getting up in time soon. Finish up drinks and collect your bets because this fight is over.
Hello?
Good morning, kid. I need you to come in for a job.
Okay. Rosales has got the lion's share of the winnings in a briefcase. He's getting on a train for San Diego later on today. You're going to be on that train with an extraction team. Charles, little Mickey, and the kid. You are there to watch the kid who is there to watch them. See how they work. Under no circumstances does anybody open that briefcase. Do you understand?
Yep. Watch the kid and get the briefcase.
So this chick is drunk, and I mean very drunk, disgustingly drunk, to where you don't really want to do anything, but then you're like, this is a great opportunity. So, you know, start making out and head up into Bastion's parents' room, and I'm talking long dark hair, no underwear. Anyway, the second I decide not to go through with it and be the better guy, I'm a good guy. You listening? Lola, are you paying attention?
Waving your fucking hand in my face, Mickey. And I'm sure that Travis isn't here about your little frat boy fantasy.
Travis, you like girls?
How are you liking the job so far?
It's not what I expected.
Well, what did you expect?
I'm just ready to get some blood on my shirt.
We're stealing a briefcase. There's gonna be no need for violence.
Do you guys see a lot of violence?
Yes, we do. Last night, for example, I saw a man kick another man to death.
That's awesome.
Yeah, it was.
That's enough.
Forgive my cousin for being so apprehensive about our line of work.
I didn't know you two were related.
Yeah, his mother's my mom's sister.
You don't see the family resemblance? Look at this. Picture perfect.
Fuck off me, Mickey. My face looks nothing like your fucking fugly face.
Wait. Fugly means fucking ugly. So I'm fucking ugly?
That's a lot of ugly.
Yeah. Besides, I know I'm gorgeous. Doesn't matter.
Okay. I bet $20 that you can't even spell gorgeous.
Gorgeous. G-O-R-G-E-O-U-S.
Oh, wow. So you can spell.
Yeah. It's George O-U-S, dumbass.
Dumbass. Okay, was it me or you who spilled food all over themselves when they were talking up the girl at the shop?
It's not the entire story. It's not how it happened. Travis, have you heard the story of Roy the Rat?
He does need to hear that
story.
Wasn't
talking to you.
No, I haven't.
There once was a rat named Raleigh. Not but a word ever said. Then came a day. He had too much to say. That's Raleigh the Rat is dead. No, truth is, we just beat the shit out of him behind her store.
All right, Big Rob, what's the big idea, huh?
I'll tell you what the big idea is.
Little Miss Ruby in the red corner
goes down in the fourth, and you bet all your money on that exact scenario. What?
Can you repeat that exactly the same way you just said it? Just start.
Red corner?
Nope.
You want me to, like, repeat it?
Yeah, just kind of, yeah, try that again.
Little Miss Ruby.
No, please skip that part.
So, scenario.
That's it, right there.
What?
You did it for me.
What?
I feel better.
You're a freak. What?
You're saying it wrong.
How do you say it? What? Wait, what word am
scenario.
I saying wrong?
Scenario. Scenario. Scenario.
Wait. Tired of this, Charles?
Only humans say that, so you're
right. Yeah.
Go fetch me some words.
You're a hick. You're a dirty hick. In Deliverance.
No. My dad says scenario.
Dad, is it scenario or scenario?
Shut up. Charles.
Charles?
Shut up!
Scenario.
Charles, we go back, all right? It's usually you and me taking out the trash.
French, Gugulanga, something like that.
You're not gonna hit a guy with glasses.
Oh, Mickey, hold him.
Got him.
Why?
All right, the fight was fixed.
You knew the fight was fixed? I lost a lot of money on that, you son of a bitch!
Calm down, Charles. Calm down.
Okay, how did you know?
I can't say.
How did you know?
All right, I'm with Rosales. Ruby and I have been working with him for a month now. Only a month.
Just a month.
Yeah. He's the one who told me the fight was fixed. I'm sorry I couldn't tell you guys, okay? They're transporting a large portion of the winnings in a briefcase tomorrow. I can help you guys steal it.
Ask him how they're transporting it.
You heard the man. Answer him!
On a train, all right? On a train in the morning.
Why a train?
Because Rosales wanted to use public transport just in case things went south. More witnesses.
Okay, how updated is this?
Rosales told me himself this morning. I'm sorry. What was I supposed to do?
It's on me. It's my fault. Spare the rod, spoil the child. Little Mickey, let him go. Charles, remind him why they call you the Boo.
Rob. Be Rob. Let me. Rob. Come on.
Rob, please don't do this. Please don't, Rob. We can work this out. I can pay you. I can do anything.
Wait. Now you're of no use to me. Charles, proceed.
Bite the curb!
No fucking way. No fucking way.
Charles!
God!
You guys hungry? What if they have a waitress or something on this train?
They don't have waitresses on trains.
Are you sure? Don't they? Anyway, Travis, the moral of the story is, come around, you get a head stomp courtesy of Charles Kirkpatrick.
Did Charles really do that?
Yeah. Yeah, he did. You want to ask him yourself?
Hey, Charlie.
I just got done telling the kid a story about you.
Mick, we came here to work, not tell stories.
Calm down. The story's about you, Captain Kirk.
No! I told you I didn't like that nickname. Now shut the fuck up and take some responsibility.
Keep up with this conversation. Just leave my scratchers. I've never lost.
Really?
Bullshit. You throw out all the losers.
Unlike you. Okay, see, Travis, what Lola's not gonna tell you is I'm the three winners by the end of today. And I could make it big and never see these faggots ever again.
Quit being such an asshole, Mick.
Thank you.
You're thanking him?
Oh my god.
Lover's luck, Lola. Sorry.
How the fuck did you get that? Fuck you. I bet you took all the money out of his wallet too, huh?
Yeah.
You think this guy's someone to look up to because he can dick around all day and get away with it?
Here.
Thanks.
Arrived at Carl's Bad Village.
That's our guy.
Please stand clear of the closing doors.
Keep your fucking head back, you're gonna blow our cover.
Departing from Carl's Bad Village.
Is that the guy we're stealing from?
Next stop, Encinita Station.
Were you not listening to Lola this morning? Hello? I'm about to put Rosales down for a nap. Yes, sir. Travis, go to the restroom and clean your face. You're bringing attention to us.
Maybe you shouldn't have broken my fucking
nose. You say one more goddamn word, and I mean one more word. I swear to the Savior himself, I'll knock out your two front teeth and make you swallow them whole.
Please do, I insist.
Here's that blanket, sir.
Gracias. Hay algún cuerpo frío en el tren?
Sí, hay una manta por el cuarto de baño. ¿Quieres que estumbre a su amigo?
Hacer lo que tienes que hacer.
I'll be back with some water.
Let's cut the bullshit. You're gonna give me the damn briefcase.
Why would I do such a thing?
Because if you don't, I'm gonna fuck you up.
Interesting ultimatum. But one part has me confused.
Oh yeah? What's that?
What are you gonna do about the cyanide you just ingested? You don't really think there's waitresses on this train, do you?
Charles is dead now.
What?
What took you so long?
I was attacked.
Sit down.
I was attacked. Okay. There was a lady.
What are you talking about?
In the bathroom, there was a waitress lady. A waitress lady, okay.
What?
Waitress. Waitress lady.
How?
I told you they have waitresses.
She is this.
How the fuck did you get that?
This is what she tried attacking me with. That's what I'm trying to fucking say. It was an accident. I seriously didn't mean to.
What do you mean it was an accident?
She's dead. I think I killed her.
Oh, wait. Please tell me that you didn't just leave her in there.
I didn't know what to do.
Do you realize what you could have done? Someone could walk in there, make a big scene about it, causing the train to stop.
Travis. I'm gonna need you to stand guard at the south entrance while little Mickey handles your situation downstairs. Then
I'm not taking care of the kid.
Does it look like he can handle it right now? Go. Now.
Where was that intensity last night?
Approaching downtown San Diego.
God, he's such a douche.
I'm sure he doesn't mean it.
Wow. You seriously still look up to that guy?
I guess.
I get it. The money and the adrenaline. Makes you feel like you won the jackpot, right? Raleigh? It was my jackpot. Know what you're thinking. Why would I go all in if I knew that it could end like this? Because I was in love.
Approaching downtown San Diego.
Here, give me the syringe and go. Travis, just be safe.
Notify the nearest conductor.
Where is she?
Thank you for riding the California.
What time is it?
For train times and ticket information, please visit our website at www.cacruiser.org.
What'd you say? Let's go up. You want to go up?
Mm-hmm.
What was this?
Departing from downtown San Diego. Please stand clear of the closing doors.
Travis, could you please let me in? Like, now?
Hello, Lola. Nice of you to let us drop by. Instincts. I knew you and Rob were close. I knew you couldn't be completely trusted after he died. So that pin I gave you as a tracking device. They all do. Always have. So I keep track of people. Tape her to the chair.
What?
Tape her to the chair.
Oh, Robinson, no. Mickey, don't do this.
Little Mickey. Tape her mouth shut. I don't want to listen to her cry. You know, when I was a kid, I had a dog. A boxer. Beautiful animal. Sweetheart, too. God, my dad loved that dog. He had a picture of him and her over the fireplace. At one point, I thought he loved the dog more than he loved me. Until one day, he came up on her unaware. He meant to pet her while she was eating. She snapped. Got him. Good. After a few stitches, very few, and a lot of complaining, because my dad was a fucking pussy. You know, they say, don't bite the hand that feeds you. You know what my dad did? He put her down. You didn't set it up. Give me the sedative, the stuff you're supposed to use on Rosales.
I know what you meant.
Okay, give me that. Dad. Give it to me. And get the fuck out. Now. Get out.
You deaf? Fucking stupid! Get out! Now!
Travis, let's go.
No. The kid stays. He needs to see what happens when you cross me.
Where you going?
Who's gonna die next? It's just joking, man.
It's not funny, though. Your dad killed your cousin. Haven't you ever thought he could do the same to you or me?
Yeah, I thought about it, but we're a different breed. What if we just got lucky? No, luck has nothing to do with it. Okay, I'm an expert in luck. Better than this? A hammock. In like the Bahamas or the dead. Yeah, because you did it. And that just proves luck has nothing to do with today, okay?
Yes.
You gonna keep making me play dad?
No.
Can we leave?
Yeah, I guess we can just get it over with.
Sorry, kid. Didn't mean to spook you. Thought you had the stomach for this.
You're turning your back on me?
We both are.
What the ever-loving fuck do you hope to accomplish with that?
I'm gonna end you. Travis, grab the briefcase. Leave.
And to think, I was the one who taught you how to hold a gun, little Mickey.
Just Mickey will do.
What just happened?
I killed my father!
We're gonna skip town for a while.
What about the things I have in my life, you know? School, friends, food I like, In-N-Out's one. What about my family?
Forget family, forget friends, forget school. What kind of psycho wants to go to school? Forget, what did you say, In-N-Out? In-N-Out sucks, okay? Newsflash, Five Guys. Don't give me that face, okay? We got money and luck. What more do you need? What more do you need?
Okay, how are we gonna offer this briefcase?
You gonna have fun now? Are we okay?
Yeah.
Let's open this bad boy.
Mashed potato.